I'm going to show you guys some common printing defects that I think allowed me to score this book at such a good price. What is up, everybody? Welcome to the Paper Chase channel. Thanks for tuning in. This one's going to be informative, a little bit exciting, a little bit of an unboxing. But before we dive into this, please, if you would like to support the channel, hit the like button. Consider subscribing at the end if you like this type of content. And check out the description links below for where I sell comic books. So I have a hell of a mail call today. This book, as I haven't been doing this super long, but I have come across quite a bit of books in my time, and I have yet to run into an Amazing Spider-Man 300. That's what this video is today. I'm going to open it up. I'm going to show you guys the condition of this book, or at least what I hope it is after unboxing it. But I'm going to also tell you what I paid for it and why I think this is an absolute steal for this book in this condition. And I want to know if you guys agree. So I'm going to crack this thing open right now, set up the overhead camera. We're going to evaluate the condition of this together. I'll go over those printing defects. And then at the end, we'll talk about what I paid. All right, so real quick before we look at the book, this is how you ship a expensive single issue comic. For anybody wondering, this seller, This seller here shipped this extremely well. It was cardboarded for rigidity, put in a mailer for vapor barrier, or put in a mailer for moisture protection. And then all of it was just in this giant box. That is how you ship a single multi-hundreds of dollar issue comic book, in case you're wondering. So kudos to that seller. Thank you very much. And here is the book here. So we're going to pop this baby open. And at a first glance, like I said, we are doing this together. If I see something that I don't like, well, you're going to hear it first. At a first glance, inside the bag looks great. Nothing to complain about yet. But, so like I said, I'm going to show you guys some printer defects on here that otherwise people might say, hey, this is an issue with this book. And if somebody doesn't really know too much of what they're talking about as far as grading goes, they might think that this is a lower grade copy than what it actually is. So this is a Copper Age book. Copper Age typically goes from about 1986 to around the 2000s range. This is very early Copper Age, so this was printed in 1988. I'm going to show you another book by the same artist that was printed around the same time, even has the same ad on the background, and though they are different publishing companies, has the same type of printer defect, so pretty interesting. All right, so let's just start here on the front of the cover. So obviously this is super hard to get in high grade because of the black all down the spine here. Looking down the spine, we're looking for spine ticks, obviously, and I think our biggest one is going to be right there by my thumb. I think that's our biggest spine tick on the front cover here. Other than that, looks pretty good. You have another one right here. Again, not as big as that one, as we just talked about. You've got some minor wear at the bottom left corner. That in the notes would be notated as very light wear, bottom left corner of the book. Other than that, this is extremely nice for this copy. This is very high grade so far. So let's talk some of the printing defects that I was talking about earlier. So if you see the bottom of the book here, where you kind of look like it's missing, it's kind of speckled. So some people might say, oh, that's color lift or that's rubbing or something like that. That's not. This is uniform in a lot of areas, and it's actually, if you some color lift that would actually remove the black ink completely. When you were to do a shine like this, you might also have a loss of gloss. As you can see, the gloss is even throughout. And then if you look at other issues of this, so if you're curious about a defect, go look at other graded copies of the book. Look at 9.6s and 9.8s, high grade copies, and see if you see any of these similar defects on those. If they are on those, then more than likely this is a printing issue. So what this is right here, this missing color speckles throughout, this is just part of the printing process. This could be due to where it was at in the printing lineup. It could be due to how much ink was left in the ink dispensers when this thing finally got inked. But this is a printing defect. This is something that CGC is not going to flag you for. unless it's really, really severe. And I would not count this as extremely severe. So if somebody were to be selling this book, they might see that and think, hey, you know, this is in poor condition because it's missing a little color here and there. Not the case. Let's go to printing defect number two. And that is the edge of this book here. You see all the wavy lines. It almost looks like rat chew or like silverfish damage. And that is not. This is the way the paper was cut off the printing press. And I'm going to show you another book, again, that's very similar, that has this exact thing. You can see the top portion of it is very straight. Keep in mind, if this were to be silverfish damage, this silverfish would have only had to choose this side of the book and go in a perfect straight line. Highly unlikely. Silverfish damage is pretty much speckled throughout. It's very random, but we can see the bottom edge of this book here is very straight, so that looks great. So again, this is something that somebody might think, hey, this has got some wear on the edge of the book here, but that's not the case. This is how the book was cut. Now, real quick, I'm going to put this down and I'm going to show you another book that's very similar. Same artist, right? You can see this is a high grade copy, 9.6. Same artist. Same, you're going to find it's close to the same ad on the background. I don't know if it's exactly the same, but I think it's pretty close to the same ad. But if we look at the top section of this, we can see the exact same waviness. And we look at the bottom, we can see the same thing. This is, you know, the ripples or the jagged, perforated edges here on the page. And this book graded a 9.6. This is both at the top and at the bottom. So this is just more proof that this is just a printing defect, nothing to worry about here. Pretty crazy, same artist, Todd McFarlane, very similar covers, same year as well. This, I believe, came out in May of 88, and then this one is September of 88. So pretty interesting there. Pretty cool. So just a quick recap before we flip this thing over. We've got a few noticeable spine ticks, probably one or two that I would say are prevalent that the CGC grader is going to note. We have very light wear at the bottom left corner. Everything else is extremely clean, and we have some typical printer defects on this comic here. Now, here's the scary part. Similar ad on the back, but this back cover is just impossible to get in high grade. So we're going to go through this very slowly. This looks great so far. We have a lot of very just little tiny spine stress lines here that hopefully some of those will come out with a press. Hopefully we won't have too many of them that's leaving the color break mark. I think this is past the point where they're going to say you have one or two spine ticks. I think they're going to sum this up to one defect, and I think they're going to just say light spine stress lines. But another important thing to keep in mind is when they're looking at this, they are also comparing this to all the other Amazing Spider-Man 300s that they have graded. And the severity of how they hit the grade on these spine ticks is going to be compared to other ASM 300s. In reality, this is extremely good condition for this book here. Now, you're probably noticing this right here, and you might be thinking, oh, that's some more wear. It is not. This is part of the printing cut, because you can see that's a perfect straight line. And then look, if we look at the top here, we can see another one, very similar, not quite as prominent, but right there is the same thing. So perfect straight line, precisely, you know, exactly parallel with each other. This is something that came off the printing press. All you can do at this point is hope that the grader that you're getting is pretty seasoned and knows that these things are part of the printing process. We have very, very light color lift on the back, which is great. We have no creases whatsoever on this book at all. So, yeah, that's it. The page quality on the inside, white pages, for sure. And there he is, right there. That's the first full, what some people say is the full appearance of Venom. He does have an entire panel with his name in ASM 299. But that's the first appearance of Venom right there. Swinging into action. Pretty badass. This is before he had the elongated tongue that I think Eric Larson gave him. Correct me in the comments if I'm wrong. Sure you will. So, very nice, very happy, a gorgeous, gorgeous Copper Age book. Pleased to have it in the collection. All right, now that we've looked at the book in totality, we know everything looks great. No surprises. Again, a few spine ticks, some very minor wear at the bottom corner here. What do I think this book is going to get? The bare minimum. What I think this book is going to get, I think this book is going to get a 9.2. That's my prediction. 9.2 bare minimum, possibly a 9.4. All right, we're back. So there we saw the condition of it. I'm pretty pleased with it. There's nothing too alarming or new that I did not see on camera. And I'm happy with my decision that I made. Now, what did I pay for this book here? Well, I'll let you guess, give you 5 seconds to guess what I paid for this book in this condition. I paid a total of $450. Now, some people that may not have price shopped ASM 300s before might think like, oh wow, that's a lot of money. It is a lot of money. But keep in mind, it's very hard to find below 700 in this condition that I found. So if you find the right seller and you know what to look for, I think you can find you a great deal out there. So that's it. Here it is. ASM 300, a classic Copper Age key, probably the king of copper, as I think it's known throughout the comic book community. Let me know again what you guys think in the comment below. Am I completely wrong in all of this? Do you not agree with my great assessment? Do you think I paid about average? I think what I got was an absolute steal again for this condition. Do you completely disagree? Please let me know in the comments below. I think one of the greatest things about this community is everybody is constantly learning and molding their own opinions and knowledge on all of these assortments of books. And I'd love to hear your information. Thank you so much again for checking out the video. Please hit that like button to support the channel. Consider subscribing. And we'll see you on the next video.